Hey everyone, it's Nicole again from Nicole's Needlework, and I'm here to show you part two of my 20 years of stitching. So I'll get started. This is a Lizzie Kate monthly. I'm assuming it's February because of the hearts and everything. It's an old one. Another old Lizzie Kate spring boxer. And another Lizzie Kate, Forever Yours. It was, this is a pink, 28 count pink and white gingham. And here's another older Lizzie Kate, spring ABCs, I believe. A really old, I think that's Bent Creek boxer. This is pretty large linen. And then a few of my friends, Karen's Handiwork, Faye, Carolina Stitcher, and Amy from Down Sunshine Lane, the owner of Down Sunshine Lane, we decided to do a kind of a stitch along. We each made each other some Prairie Schooler friendship from the friendship booklet. So this one is Amy's. She made this one for me. This one is Karen's. Karen made this one. And this one is from Faye. So Faye stitched that one. And then, so we each stitched each other different ones. And those again, Prairie Schooler, I think Friendship 2 booklet or leaflet. Here's a Country Cottage Needleworks, Cherry Hill, and this is probably from around 2006 or 7, and these don't have a date, most likely about 4 years ago. Here's another Lizzie Kate that looks like April, March or April, that one is, probably April for me. I can't remember. I'm already starting off wrong. This is another Lizzie Kate little one. Country Cottage Needleworks. And here's a Blackbird Designs. What the heck? There's a needle in there. Sorry about that. This is from one of their booklets, and as you can see, I was going to use this fabric to make it into a little pillow. Haven't done that yet, obviously. Here's a real old one. This has to be from, oops, it's upside down. This one has to be from around 2006, because I got this when I lived in St. Petersburg, Florida at Silk Road Needle Arts, which used to be my L&S there. And this is a Just Nan, and I had a lot of fun stitching it. I love all the little specialty stitches. It wasn't my usual thing, but I really enjoyed stitching it. Here's an older Shepherd's Bush, and I actually gave this to my mom and took it back from her, because I told her I was gonna get it framed. Well, you see how that went. This is from early 2000s or 90s. I'd say 2000s, maybe. I can't remember. It's so bad how I don't remember this. But it's all in my Flickr album. So this is a bright needle design, and I did actually have this framed. I have it pinned on foam core. And I actually did have it framed, but took it out of the frame. This was at my mom's also, and I don't know where I think she took it out of the frame, and I took it back from her. So here we have a little house needlework, Simple Joys. Stitched this a little while ago. It looks like it's on 32 count buttercream. And a bright needle, Blackbird Designs. Oh, 2010. Here we have a Shepherd's Bush, 3 pale eggs. It's a Shepherd's Bush kit. And I actually do have the mats, Jill Renzel mats for these. I don't know where I put them. They're around here somewhere. Cats. The cats drive me crazy today. Again. Here is a sprinkled country cottage. This is using Belsoir silks, 40 count linen, and I think it's 40 count. Yeah, I think, sorry about that. I think it is 40 count. And again, here's some backing fabric that I was going to make a pillow. One day. Here is a, these were thread packs from Little House Needleworks. So it had 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 different thread packs. And this was a lot of fun to stitch. I think this is Belsoir. Yeah, it's Belsoir also. Belsoir thread packs. And this is 32 count, like side linen. And here is a Shepherd's Bush kit. And the little carriage house freebie. And I actually did start all the alphabets. I got up to like I and kind of gave up. So. Here's another little, I think this is another one of those little thread packs. It's either Little House or Country Cottage. Here's another Shepherd's Bush kit. Peter's Patch. I did do Sophie's Roses also, but gave her to a friend. Love this little dragonfly button. And here is a, I think this is Bent Creek. It's like seasonal sampler or something. You have winter and then goes into spring, summer, fall. This was a lot of fun to stitch. All the cute little buttons and everything. Another Shepherd's Bush kit. Little snowman, snow hill. Here's another patriotic snowman, I think is this one. I love all this pattern darning into the cute little mitten. And that was quite a while ago that I stitched this. I think I was living in Georgia at the time. Another little Easter Shepherd's Bush kit. I think this one is Hunt. Here is a Shepherd's Bush kit, Harvest Moon. I was really into Shepherd's Bush for a long time. Still love Shepherd's Bush. But for a while, that was pretty much all I stitched. I was obsessed. Cute little tiny Shepherd's Bush kit there. And the matching girl that goes with him. Very cute. Here's a little, I'm sorry, I do not remember the name of this chart. It's like Live Simply and I can't remember who it's by. But pretty little Quaker. And I just use Silken Colors, one strand. This is 40 count. In 2007, that's when I stitched that. Here's a cute little Lizzie Kate. Housework never killed anyone, but why take a chance? I completely agree. Love that one. Here's a little house, Autumn Harvest. Uh, This is Heart and Hand, I believe. I did a bunch of these monthly designs, and I think it was in 99 or 2000. It was before I had my first son, and I don't think I ever did November, December. I did all the months. There's another little Lizzie Kate monthly. I used to be really into monthly designs. I think this is Country Cottage Needleworks. Give thanks for what your garden grows. Here is a Prairie Schooler winter sampler. Little Shepherd's Bush Halloween kit. Right. Here is a little house or country cottage geranium house. I really like this one. I love geraniums. I usually have them on my front porch every year. I didn't this year, but next year definitely, because I missed them this year. And red. I always love red. Red's my favorite. Here's a country cottage. The tea room. And I believe this is 32 count lamb's wool jobelaine. And here's another country cottage. Needlework shop. Same lamb's wool. I think it's jobelaine because I don't think it's Lugana. Here's a little Quaker, Faith, Hope, Love, and I'm not sure who this pattern is by. It's a long time ago that I stitched this. I think this is a little trilogy freebie. It's one of those, Heart and Hand, Bent Creek, and I think another designer joined up. I'm so sorry for the shaky camera. And create a trilogy. And I can't remember who the other one was. This is a little Bent Creek snowman. Cute. These are kind of all mixed in. Old and older and old. Here's a little house, Acorn Hill. Lizzie Kate, Jake's birth sampler. So, little house. Lavender and Lace freebie right there. Just Nan kit and I mentioned last time I used to have a cross stitch shop, and this was a class project we did with the shop. And that was back in 1997. We did that. My shop only lasted about 10 months. It was in downtown Atlanta. Not a great location. Wasn't easy to get to. Not good parking. I was only 23, so it was a huge, huge lesson I learned. I was going to reopen, but then I just decided not to. And I still would like to one day. I would love to have a shop again one day, but not right now. Here's those monthly. There's January. They're not in order. And there's May. I think this is a little house, or I think it's a little house thread pack. I love this. And I was going to use this fabric for a backing. There's a little shepherd's bush, tiny flag. It's supposed to be made into a little pillow. Did I do that? No. Little house. I think this is two white houses. I'm going to have a big Little House Needleworks. I did the Little House Neighborhood. I did that as a stitch along with a group of people back in 2008. And that was a fun one to stitch.
is a little shepherd's bush kit. And this is by the Good Huswife. For some reason, the name of this design is leaving me. I'll try to put it in the video when I upload. Little shepherd's bush kit, sweetheart. Here's a little house freebie. And I believe this is Heart and Hand. Spring alphabet, and I stitched it twice. Don't ask why. There was a reason. I can't remember now. But I used two little different buttons and put a little dragonfly in that one. I don't know why. Here's a little Lizzie Kate freebie. Little house. Blossoms and blackbirds. Here's a little house, strawberry house. I also did Queen Bee, and I gave that to a friend. So, oops. This is, I think, if I could get it right, Country Cottage Berry Patch. I don't know if you can hear my kids. They're playing. They're being very loud. They create their own games. It's pretty funny. And this is Quaker Strawberry. I think it's by Little by Little. Here's a little... I think this was a freebie. And I cannot remember the designer. Sorry, I cannot remember that designer. I might have it in my notes and I'll write it. I'll put it when I upload. Here's a little prairie schooler. And this is in GHI book, I think. I just did H. I love bees. Here's a little shepherd's bush kit. Thankful. This is Prairie Moon by Little House, and it's Belle Soie. Looks like vintage exemplar, 32 count. I did 2/2 with that one. That was before I really got into 40 count and 1/2, which is my favorite. Here's a little Lizzie Kate Halloween design. And we have a blackbirds, Quaker. I think this is Quaker Garden, part of the loose feathers. That was done in 2006, so about 10 years ago. And this is 32 count pear by Lakeside Linens. Here's another Little House Needleworks. This is 36 count natural linen, 1/2. Little House. And I can't remember the names, but I'll try and post them. Little house. I like these two girls. They look cute next to each other. One was a kit, like a kit for a market or something. It's been a while. And you may notice I don't sign or put the date. I probably should, because like going back now I can't remember, but I don't, because I guess in my mind I feel like it might take away from the design if I do that, which is silly, because when other people do it, it doesn't take anything away. So it's probably just more laziness on my part. Anyway, here's a shepherd's bush my earth kit, and my friend, she did the different lettering, so it wasn't so funky. So I used her lettering on a lot of things. Another shepherd's bush kit. That looks like vintage country mocha. Love this. I used to really love Halloween designs, and I kind of got away from them. And this is Quaker Family, I think, or Family Quaker. Shepherd's Bush kit. Very sweet. Sweet colors. Here is a Country Cottage. And this was thread packs. And I have the buttons somewhere. I just haven't put them on. One day I'll do that. This is a drawn thread. And it's Marriage of Minds. But I was going to do the whole thing. And I ended up just cutting off the top. Because I got tired of it. I was thinking of putting the day we got married on here. Here's a Blackbird Designs Beneath the Sunlit Sky. This is on a 32 count hand-dyed linen. Shepherd's Bush, Scatter Freedom. Tiny little Shepherd's Bush sheet, posé. Here is Prairie Schooler Autumn Sampler. It goes with winter. Here's another one of those Belsois thread packs by Little House. This is on 32 count. Another Little House. Drawn thread. It's long. I can see if I can get the whole thing in there. This is Sunflower Bell Pole, I believe, by Drawn Thread. And here we have Kindred Spirits, Primitive Needle. And I love this one. I think I did Belsois with that one. Here's a real old one. It's Bright Needle Key West Sampler. Pretty colors. Here's another little thread pack quilting. Shepherd's Bush Snow. This is like on 10 count Heatherfield or something. It's really thick. I also did a couple other of these. I think I sold them though. At one point I did sell quite a few Little House and other things that I knew I wasn't gonna hang up. So I did sell some things. I may actually try that again, put some stuff on my blog. People want them for shop models or whatever. So I may do that in the future. This is Pear Tree Inn, Little House. Yeah, I was obsessed with Little House Needleworks for a long time. Little Lizzie Kate. This was in a magazine. Shepherd's Bush, Merry Christmas. Oh, I'm getting to the end. Bent Creek. I think this is, I can't remember what sampler this is. Sorry. Little House, Needle and Thread. There's a little You and I and Friends. It's supposed to be a fob. There's another Little House, The Rain Fell. I love this linen. It's so pretty. And more of those Heart and Hands monthly September. They're not in order, obviously. October, March, February, June, April, and July. Like I said, I never did do November or December. Oh well. Shepherd's Bush Kit, Shepherd's Hill. The little Shepherd's Bush, teeny tiny Liberty. I'd make a cute little fob or something. This is a Bent Creek design, Full Moon Rising. It was in a magazine. They also had the sun. They had the sun, so companion. This is Bent Creek, Seashore Row, or something like that. I have all the buttons for this. I just haven't put them on. I think this is a trilogy. Tricky Treats. Now I've got to find out who else was in the trilogy, because it's going to drive me crazy. Bent Creek, Heart in Hand, and someone else. Shepherd's Bush, Take My Heart, and Be Mine. This was a freebie by Midsummer Night, I think. Midsummer Night Designs, Deborah, I believe, was the designer. I think this is Country Cottage Daisy Sampler. So cute. I love the linen. Here we have Lizzie Kate, and this is, I can't remember the name, but I only did 6, and there's like 12, so I just kind of cut it off, but it was fun. I think this is, Lamb's Wool, Joe Blanigan. Another little, I think that's a Lizzie Kate freebie. I'm really almost to the end here, guys. Little House, and look, I've got a stain. Somehow, I don't know. And here's a Mirabilia, my only Mirabilia I've ever stitched. And this is Winter Queen. At one point I was completely obsessed with Mirabilias and Lavender and Lace. And I started many. And this is the only one I finished. Look at those beads. So pretty. And she was supposed to have another, like, longer string of beads. I ended up not doing it. And here, on my bedroom wall, I have Peace Angel by Lavender and Lace. I don't want to get too close because I think there's dust on it. It doesn't have glass. And normally I don't frame with glass, but I think I might start because I don't like that. And if I go around here, hopefully I'm not making you dizzy. I have Scarlet House. I have Sarah Elizabeth Brook. And this one doesn't have dust, so it's okay. The funny thing about this is the frame is exactly what Tanya used to frame her Sarah. And I didn't even know. I was at the frame shop for over an hour, and I found this one in. Ended up being funny that it was the same. I do have other frame pieces, but they're still in a box. This is my myth. Look, this is where I was recording my podcast earlier. See the mess I left? And there's the bad cats. So that's real life there, people. Anyway, last thing I have in here. This was a long time. This was like 2007. Ish, 2008. I don't remember the designer of that. And I've got this Little House Bell Pepper sampler, Bell Pepper Christmas sampler, something. And last thing is a Shepherd's Bush. The stockings were hung. And that's it. That's everything in my tub. And I do have some more frame pieces I will show another time. This is already almost 30 minutes. So I will just talk to you guys probably in a week or so. And again, hope you guys have a great weekend. Bye.